ओके, वन क्वेश्चन वॉज रिलेटेड टू दिस. दिस पिक्चर वॉज गिवेन एंड क्वेश्चन वॉज आस्क दैट विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फीचर्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द रीजन ऑफ दिस गिवेन पिक्चर. ओके, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट दिस पिक्चर रिलेट्स टू विच ऑर्गेन, विच स्ट्रक्चर. बेसिकली दिस इज द सेरिबेलर फोलिया. वी नो दैट सेरिबेलम इज अरेंज्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेरियस लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स, एज यू कैन सी आर्बरवाइटा टाइप्स. लाइक दिस इज अ ट्री सॉर्ट ऑफ एंड दीज आर वेरियस लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स अराउंड दैट. सो दिस होल पिक्चर इज ऑफ सेरिबेलम. नाउ विद इन द सेरिबेलम, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस वट आर द यू नो वट आर द फीचर्स इफ द इफ देर इज सेरिबेलर सिंड्रोम. ओके, so first of all we can see that first of all ataxia occurs, which can be that is you know which can be intermittent or jerky. Okay, and second thing, dysmetria can happen. I mean suppose when the patient he reaches out his finger to something, he either overshoots that or it deviates from that particular object. So this is called as the past pointing. Third is adiadocokinesis or dysdiadocokinesis. Okay, in this what happens, like rapidly we can do normally, we can do rapidly you know alternating movements like flexion, extension, pronation, supination. But in these patients, this is they perform this in a very clumsy manner. Okay, fourth, asynergy occurs. What is asynergy? It is the breakdown of smooth coordination between muscles. Okay, performing a function. Like cerebellum is important for the synchronization and coordination of movements, but if cerebellum is injured, then asynergy occurs. Hypotonia can occur because cerebellum is also responsible in some extent too for muscle tone. Okay, and intention tremors are there. Like patient, whenever patient does something, for example, whenever patient does something, he मतलब tremors occur. Okay, but in opposite to this, there is another type of tremors called as resting tremors. They occur in the Parkinsonism. Okay, but intention tremors occur in the cerebellum, especially in the demyelinating disorders of cerebellar peduncles. Okay, apart from this, the patient is having slurring or scanning speech called as dysarthria. Okay, apart from that, nystagmus can occur, which is mostly horizontal. Okay, and it mainly occurs when the vermis of the cerebellum is involved. Okay, so these all are the features of cerebellar lesion. Now again I am coming to this picture. So again, suppose this time they have asked that what are the features if this part is injured. Okay, now you should know what are the layers of cerebellum. There are basically three layers of cerebellum. First is outer molecular layer. Okay, middle Purkinje cell layer, and below that is granule cell layer. Okay, and you should know this that within one more thing. That the cerebellar cortex consists of gray matter and here is the white matter. Okay, so first of all you can see that this outermost pink colored structure, this is the molecular layer. Okay, molecular layer consists of mainly the basket cells. Okay, basket cells, and you know molecular layer mein there are very few cells. On the other hand, below this molecular layer, this pink layer, there is one single cell layer which is not visible in this, that is very that is composed of Purkinje cells. Okay, these Purkinje cells, they make a layer which is single layered in contrast to other two layers, and these Purkinje cells, they are flask shaped cells. Okay, these Purkinje cells are like this. Okay, and their dendrites are towards the outer molecular layer. These are Purkinje cells, and their axons are down. Okay, And these Purkinje cells, these are the only, you know, output cells to the deep cerebellar nuclei. We will read about the deep cerebellar nuclei later, but Purkinje cells, they are the only output zone. Output zone, okay? And third thing, below that there is granule cell layer, this blue colored, you can see dark blue. Okay, this is composed of granule cells and the Golgi cells, especially Golgi type 2 cells. Okay, and below this there is this dark pink structure. This whole is the white matter. Okay, so I'm repeating, outermost is molecular layer, then Purkinje cell layer, then granule cell layer. Okay, outer molecular layer composed of basket cells, then Purkinje cell layer, not visible here, composed of single layer of flask shaped cells called as Purkinje cells, and below that there is this blue colored layer. This is composed of granule cells or the your Golgi cells. Okay, granule cells are the most numerous among them. Okay, now within the white matter, I'm coming to deep cerebellar nuclei now. You just need to know by now that there are four deep cerebellar nuclei. Okay. Which are from lateral to medial, you can remember it as mnemonic is dogs eat good food. Okay, so lateral most is dentate nucleus. Okay, after that, eat, E for emboliform. Okay. After that, G for globose nuclei, okay, and F for vestigial nucleus.